हेलो एंड वेलकम टू इट्स टुमारो न्यूज एंड दिस इज हेना तलाटी। ट्रॉपिकल स्टॉर्म फ्रेड मेड लैंडफॉल ऑन मंडे आफ्टरनून इन द फ्लोरिडा पैनहैंडल नियर केप सैन ब्लास, द नेशनल हरिकेन सेंटर सेड। फ्रेड वॉज अबाउट 15 माइल्स साउथ ऑफ मरियाना, मूविंग इनलैंड एट 10 माइल्स पर आवर अकॉर्डिंग टू द नेशनल हरिकेन सेंटर। The storm's maximum sustained winds were about 50 miles per hour. Fred was expected to bring storm surge, river flooding, and possible tornadoes along the US coast, but the storm itself will quickly weaken after the landfall, according to the NHC. By evening, more than 36,000 customers were without power in northwestern Florida, according to the poweroutage.us. The storm had maximum sustained winds of 65 miles per hour at landfall, the National Hurricane Center said. Fred was one of the three storms swirling in the Atlantic Basin. Lining up behind the Fred were tropical depressions Grace, which drained the Dominican Republic and earthquake-battered Haiti on Monday, and the tropical storm Henry, which formed Monday afternoon near Bermuda. Henry became the eighth named storm in the Atlantic season. The National Hurricane Center said the tropical storm watch was in effect in Bermuda along the Panama City beach. In Florida's panhandle, lifeguards hoisted double red flags warning beachgoers against going into the Gulf of Mexico. The area braced the rain and some winds from the storm, and although no evacuations were ordered, schools and government offices were closed on Monday. The storm is expected to bring isolated maximum rainfall totals of 12 inches to the Florida Big Bend and Panhandle through Tuesday, according to the National Hurricane Center. And heavy rainfall can be expected through the parts of southeast Alabama, portions of Georgia, and western Carolinas. Storm surge is forecast with the highest from the Indian Pass to the Stanhope River in Florida, where a surge of 3 to 5 feet is possible. A storm surge of 1 to 3 feet was forecasted for Monday from the Alabama-Florida border to Indian Pass, including Pensacola Bay and St. Andrew Bay. Tornadoes are also a threat as a storm begins to move ashore. A tornado watch covers portions of Florida, Georgia, and Alabama. Heavy rainfall and dangerous storm surge were forecast in the Panhandle and along the Big Bend area throughout the evening. The deepest water will occur along the immediate coast near and to the east of the landfall location, where the surge will be accompanied by the large waves. Surge-related flooding depends on the relative timing of the surge and the tidal cycle and can vary greatly over the short distances. In Apalachicola, water levels had risen over 3 feet above the normal levels through midday on Monday. Meanwhile, the tropical depression Grace was delivering torrential rains over the parts of Haiti and Dominican Republic, the National Hurricane said, potentially affecting recovery efforts in Haiti following a major 7.2 magnitude earthquake that struck on Saturday. Grace weakened from a storm to a tropical depression on Sunday with maximum sustained winds of 35 miles per hour, but it is expected to strengthen to a storm again on Tuesday. The tropical storm warning is in effect for some parts of the southern coast of the Cuba, including Santiago de Cuba, and for the Cayman Islands, the National Hurricane Center said. Grace was forecast to move over Hispaniola throughout the day on Monday, and the Hurricane Center predicted rainfall of up to 15 inches could cause the flash and urban floodings and possible mudslides for Haiti and the Dominican Republic through Tuesday. In Haiti, rocked by the massive earthquake Saturday that killed at least 1,300 people, first responders and the volunteers scrambled to rescue survivors as the storm moved across the country. Grace is expected to emerge in the Gulf of Mexico this week, and the U.S. Gulf Coast could be a target. AccuWeather forecasters said they are monitoring the atmospheric conditions and how they could influence where Grace will track on the weekend. These factors include the warm waters of the Gulf of Mexico as well as winds at various levels of the atmosphere. Far southern Texas remained in Grace's potential forecast path, but the storm appeared more likely to impact Mexico according to the latest forecast from the Hurricane Center issued on Monday morning. Grace was forecast to reach minimal hurricane strength of 74 miles per hour before making the landfall, the Hurricane Center said. Tropical Storm Henry had maximum sustained winds around 40 miles per hour and was about 145 miles southwest of the Bermuda as of Monday afternoon. The storm was expected to make a slow clockwise turn toward the west over the next few days, forecasters said in an advisory. The center of depression was forecast to move southeast and the south of the island territory. Though early in the storm's development, forecasters did not expect Henry to reach the U.S. coast. That's all for now. For more news updates, stay tuned with us. It's Tomorrow News, Hena Talati. For more weather updates like this, and please subscribe our channel.